Welcome to the T-minus 60 series of videos. In this video, we'll be discussing an overview of what a QMLV product is and why they are needed for space missions. So why do designers need specially qualified ICs for satellites? For one, space is harsher than the terrestrial environment due to radiation effects from charged particles and heavy ions. Secondly, satellites are very expensive, up to hundreds of millions of dollars to build and launch, which means that they should not have unforeseen failures. TI space-grade devices have varying levels of radiation tolerance levels to support low Earth orbit, medium Earth orbit, and geosynchronous orbit missions. Different missions will have various radiation requirements depending on how far away from Earth they are and how long the mission is. TI releases parts compliant to Qualified Manufacturer List Class V, which are suitable for most space applications. These parts go through extensive qualification and testing to ensure they will be reliable in space. They can be identified by the orderable part number, for example, like the one you see here. Let's read the orderable part number. The main body of the part number is comprised of the Defense Logistics Agency's Standard Microcircuit Drawing Number, or the SMD. The letter in the middle indicates that the part is Radiation Hardness Assured, or RHA, which means that every lot is tested to a total ionizing dose radiation performance set by the letter in the part number. In this case, the R means 100 Krad TID. The V in the part number indicates it is a Class V device. If you see another letter like Q or M, that indicates a military part number not suitable for space. The last letter of the part number indicates the lead finish of the part. That could be solder dip or gold plate for most TI devices. Qualifying a device to QMLV is an extensive process, as you can see here, including things like wafer lot acceptance testing, wire bond, bond pull, die shear testing, internal visual inspection to multiple degrees, temperature cycling, pre-burn-in electrical testing, burn-in for 240 hours, as well as ambient post-burn-in testing and testing over temperature. Following all that is the QCI testing that is done to prove a part has passed QMLV qualification. The QCI testing and the paperwork that accompanies a part will be discussed in the next videos in this series. For more information or to find the right space part for you, please visit ti.com/space.